أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قيل لهم اسكنوا هذه القرية وكلوا منها حيث شئتم وقولوا حطة وادخلوا الباب سجدا نغفر لكم خطيئاتكم سنزيد المحسنين فبدل الذين ظلموا منهم قولا غير الذي قيل لهم فارسلنا عليهم رجزا من السماء بما كانوا يظلمون صدق الله العظيم. The incidents that are being quoted here from the history of Bani Israel, we have already studied them in detail in Surah Al-Baqarah. But please remember that this surah was revealed before the revelation of Surah Al-Baqarah. This is Makki. But you know, these things were referred as if these were known facts, because you know the Jews knew them, their history. And recall when it was said to them, you dwell and settle in this town, هذه القرية, وَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شَيْتُمْ, and you eat thereof whatever you like. وَقُولُوا حِتَّةٌ, and go on saying, حِتَّةٌ, حِتَّةٌ, O Allah, forgive us our sins. وَدْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا, and you enter the gate of that city, bowing your heads down, not arrogantly, just as, you know, the conquerors of any city or towns or countries, they enter. نَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ خَطِيئَاتِكُمْ, we shall forgive you the evils that you have committed, or your mistakes and errors. سَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسَنِينَ, and we shall reward, increase the reward of the good doers, people who are muhsin, not only Muslim and mu'min, but they rise to the level of Muhsin. Now, according to the history of the Jews, this was the town of Jericho, Ariha. Well, you know, after the death of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, and after 40 years punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided for them, فَإِنَّا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً يَتِيهُنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, after the expiry of that period, now the generation which was, you know, born in the desert, during this, you know, in wilderness, then they became of age, and then they fought against the people who were living in Palestine, and then they conquered that country, and the first city that fell to them was Ariha or Jericho, as you know it today. But they were ordered that you enter as conquerors, not with arrogance, and you know, your heads must not be above, and your necks should not be straight and tight, but you bow your heads, just as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he entered Bakka, after the victory of Bakka, you know, his head, his forehead was touching the neck of the horse on which he was riding. فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ قَوْلًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي قِيلَ لَهُمْ, those of them who did wrong substituted a saying other than that had been said to them. So we sent upon them a scourge, a torment from the sky, بِمَا كَانُوا يَسْلِمُونَ, due to their transgressions and evil doings. وَاسْأَلْهُمْ عَنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ حَاضِرَةَ الْبَحْرِ, now there are a few incidents more which are reported here and quoted and referred to. They also belong to the history of Bani Israel. Actually, the real discourse has come to an end regarding Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Now these incidents are of a later period. One, you know, it relates to some people who were settled, and they say it was Aqaba of today. Here a tribe of Bani Israel, they were settled, and you know, they used to catch fish from the sea. It was a town on the coast, sea coast. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them to a very severe test. What was it? وَاسْأَلْهُمْ عَنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ حَاضِرَةَ الْبَحْرِ, and ask them of the, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the township standing close to the sea. Is yaduna fi sabt, when these people were transgressing regarding the law of Sabbath, because, you know, it was a very strict law for them. No work whatsoever, no earning, no worldly acts. The whole day was to be reserved for zikr, remembering Allah, reading Torah, and, you know, worshipping Allah. 6 days you work for yourself, one day you reserve for Allah. In our Sharia, the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this has been reduced to only a part of the day, after the call of Azan, you know, for Friday, and till the Friday prayer has ended. Now this, you know, law applicable in our Sharia only to this a period of about an hour or so, or not more than that. But it had, you know, a very strict application on the former Muslim Ummah. إِسْتَعْتِيهِمْ حِيْتَانُهُمْ يَوْمَ سَبْتِهِمْ. What happened? You know, the fish, they have also some understanding. They used to come very close to the coast and openly on the Sabbath days. They knew that, you know, there is one day out of the 7 days of the week in which nobody touches us. Nobody comes and, you know, catches. So they were freely coming to the coast. وَيَوْمَ لَا يَسْمِتُونَ لَا تَعْتِيهِمْ. And on the other days, they would come, they would go deep to the deep seas. كَذَلِكَ نَبْلُوهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. And this is how we put them to a very hard trial, because of their transgressions. Because there were some other transgressions also, so Allah Ta'ala put them to a very hard test, so that they can be sifted. Who are the people who really believe in Allah and His law, and who observe the law from the depths of their heart, and who are the other type of people? وَإِذْ قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِظُونَ قَوْمًا إِلَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. Now this, the people dwelling over there, they divided into three parts, three groups. One was committing this transgression, breaking this law of the Sharia of Moses, alayhi salatu wasalam. The other was, second was not transgressing itself, not breaking the law, but not forbidding them also from what they were doing, the wrong that they were doing. The third group was that they also stayed away from this sin, never committed that sin, and they continued forbidding them, oh, don't do it, this is haram. You are breaking the law of Allah, you are breaking the law of Sharia, you don't do it. Now the middle group, it said to the third group, is قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ. Where the group from amongst them, they said to them, لِمَ تَعِزُونَ قَوْمًا اللَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ. Why do admonish and advise you these people, whom Allah is going to destroy? They are, you know, doomed. They will be destroyed. أَوْ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدًا. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send upon them a very severe punishment, a very severe chastisement. قَالُوا مَعَذِلَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. This is very important. And this is, you know, one of the basic principles of deen, which you must understand. قَالُوا مَعَذِلَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. They replied, so that we can place and we can produce an excuse before our Lord, that, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we were forbidding them. We kept on forbidding them. We didn't give up our efforts to bar them and stop them from breaking the law of the Sharia. وَلَعَلَّهُ يَتَّقُونَ. And maybe, might be they may have taqwa. How do you know for sure that he is not going to listen to you? Maybe some of them listen to us. And if even a few, you know, they turn back from this sin and they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a big, you know, gain. Just as there's the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Ali, Ya Ali, لَا يَهْدِي اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمْرِ النَّعْمِ. If Allah, you know, leads even one single human being due to you towards the right path, you call to him, you are forbidding him from something wrong and you are ordering him something good, and due to your, you know, advice, if he is turning away from sin, well, this is for you more precious than red camels, you know. And they were very precious for these Arabs. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ. When they ignored the reminding, أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْحَوْنَ عَنِ السُّودِ. This is again very important. We saved those who were forbidding them. Only those who continue doing forbidding from wrong. يَنْحَوْنَ عَنِ السُّودِ. Only those were saved. وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَيِّسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. And we seized those who were transgressing with a punishment and chastisement due to their transgressions. فَلَمَّا عَطَوْا مَانَهُ. And when they arrogantly persisted on what they were forbidden to do, قُلْنَا لَهُمْ كُونُوا قِرَدَةً خَاسِهِينَ. We said to them, this command came to them, now be you apes, despised, خَاسِهِينَ. وَإِسْتَعَذَّنَ رَبُّكَ لَيَبْعَثَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And just recall, when your Lord proclaimed it, that He will appoint till the day of judgment, till the day of resurrection, people, مَنْ يَسُومُهُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ, who will be persecuting them, who will be inflicting them with the worst of punishments. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَسَرِيُّ الْعِقَابِ. Verily, your Lord is very swift in reckoning. وَإِنَّهُ لَغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. And at the same time, He is forgiving also and He is merciful also. Both these aspects, you know, these both attributes of Allah should be kept in mind at simultaneously. Now this ayah is very important. This has declared and this was foretold, you know, what had been happening to Jews even, you know, ever since. It's only from 1917 of this century that the things were changed. Well, after the Balfour Declaration, they were allowed to purchase lands and settle down in Palestine. After how much period? They were scattered in the land, in the whole of the world. After the year 70 of Christian era, when Titus, you know, he conquered Jerusalem, he demolished the Second Temple, he killed hundreds and thousands of the Jews, and then the Jews were expelled from Palestine. From 70, year 70 of Christian era, to 1917, just imagine, 1837 years, they were all, you know, this is called diaspora, scattered. وَقَطَّعْنَاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أُمَمًا. And we just scattered them in the whole of the world, in the whole of the earth, in communities. Now, this was the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we had in this very century, at least the people of my age, they know what happened, you know, in Germany. They say 6 million of them were exterminated. Some people doubt this figure, but they also say that at least 4 million were killed. Special, you know, plants were designed how to dispose of their bodies, a big number, you know. Gas chambers and all those things, designed specially. وَإِسْتَعَذَّنَ رَبُّكَ لَيَبْعَثَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ يَسُومَهُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ. They have been having punishments and punishments and punishments and punishments at the hands of the Christians. You know, I have written a book to Christians with love, and I have given, you know, the detail. There has been bitter enmity between the Christians and the Jews. It was only after Renaissance and the Reformation of religion, when, you know, Christianity was divided into Catholicism and Protestantism, that they got the support of the Protestants. They have just recently, so to say, conquered the Catholics also, when the Pope has granted them amnesty, that they are not responsible for the crucifixion of Jews. And, you know, Vatican has also recognized Israel, and the Pope is going to visit Israel very soon. And you know, the embassy of Israel will be built, and that will be in Jerusalem. وَقَطَّعْنَاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. It's the diaspora, which they call, the period of diaspora. وَقَطَّعْنَاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. We scattered them in the whole of the world. Umaman, in communities, a community here, a community there. Some Jews living in Russia, some Jews, you know, migrated to America, some here, some there. They were all scattered. This what they call diaspora. مِنْهُمُ الصَّالِحُونَ. But here Quran is doing justice to them. There are among them good people are also. وَمِنْهُمْ دُونَ ذَلِكَ. And they are the reverse also. وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ. And we have been trying them with good blessings and misfortunes. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Maybe that they return. They repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ. But then after them there succeeded unworthy generations. وَرِثُوا الْكِتَابِ. They inherited the book. You know, this book is inherited. We have also inherited Quran from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, generation after generation. Sahaba got it from the Prophet. Then the Tabi'in got it from the companions, and so on. Then the Tabi Tabin got it. And this is in the inheritance, you know, coming. Warisul Kitab, they inherited the book. Ya khudun arada hadha al adna, and they would accept the things of this low world. As has been said, you know, many a time, selling the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, selling the fatwas, you know, for some worldly gains, meager gains. وَيَقُولُونَ سَيُغْفَرُ لَنَا. The same that we also say, oh, we shall be pardoned. We shall be forgiven. Allah will forgive us. We have a special relationship with Him. We are the children of Ibrahim. We are this like sons to Allah, and very beloved of Him. And we also say, we are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, the fire of hell cannot touch us. Even if it touches us, it will be for only a few days, only number of days. يَقُولُونَ سَيُغْفَرُ لَنَا. وَإِنْ يَاتِهِمْ أَرَضٌ مِثْلُهُ يَأْخُذُوهُ. And if you know this worldly gains come to them, they again take it. أَلَمْ يُوْخَذْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِسَاقُ الْكِتَابِ. Was not the covenant of book taken from them? خُذُوا مَا أَتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاسْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah yaqulu ala Allah illa al-haq. The covenant was that they will never say on Allah except what is true. They will never concoct something, forge something, and attribute it to Allah. But darasu bafi, and they have been reading, they have been studying this book, they have been having this book with them. But darul akhiratu khairul lilladhina yattaqun. But the house of the akhirah, of the hereafter, the life of the hereafter, that is much better for those who have taqwa. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. So don't you have your intelligence, and you don't use your intelligence or intellect? وَالَّذِينَ يُمَسِّكُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ. Those who cling to the book, hold fast to the book. This is the book of Allah, hold fast. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. تَمَسُّك, اِعْتِسَام, having the same meanings. وَالَّذِينَ يُمَسِّكُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ. And they establish the prayers. إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُصْلِحِينَ. We are not going to waste the rewards of the righteous and the reformers. وَإِذْ نَتَقْنَا الْجَبَلَ فَوْقَهُمْ كَأَنَّهُ ظُلَّةٌ. And when we had raised and shook the mountain over their heads, كَأَنَّهُ ظُلَّةٌ, as if it was a canopy. وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُ وَاقِعٌ بِهِمْ. And they thought and feared that it is going to fall upon them. خُذُوا مَا أَتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. This was the covenant of the book. Now hold fast to what we have given. And the same misaq was taken from us also, as we have read in Suratul Ma'idah. So that is misaq. Misaqul Kitab, misaqul Torah, misaqul Quran. We are bound the misaq of Quran, the covenant of Quran. وَإِذْ نَتَقْنَا الْجَبَلَ فَوْقَهُمْ كَأَنَّهُ ظُلَّةٌ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُ وَاقِعٌ بِهِمْ. خُذُوا مَا أَتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاسْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ. And remember whatever is there in it. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you will have taqwa, so that you will be saved from the punishment of the hereafter, from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now another incident which happened, you know, in the beginning of the creation. I told you this surah is giving, most part of it is devoted to history, events, incidents, Ambaur Rusul, you know, major part of it. About 15 sections out of total 24, they are dedicated to the Ambaur Rusul. Then you know in the beginning, the story of Iblis and Adam. Then what will happen at the end of this world, in the hereafter. Now again an incident which took place, it is very important. وَإِذَا خَدَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ زُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ. May I just recall, when your Lord drew out from the backs of all the Bani Adam, and you know, what was drawn out? The souls. Not the human beings. You can't draw out a full man from the back of the father. You know, only the soul can be drawn out. وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. And then he made them witness on their own selves. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ. Am I not your Lord, your Master, your Creator, your Sustainer? قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. They said, why not? Surely. شَهِدْنَا. We bear testimony to it. We are witnesses to it. أَنْتَقُولُوا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Lest you should say on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, إِنَّا كُنَّا عَنْ هَذَا غَافِلِينَ Well, we were unaware of this when this misaq was taken from us. No. Your souls remember them. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us to account on the basis of this misaq, this covenant, you know, the souls will remember those things. And Hazrat Ali has been reported to have said that I remember the covenant when it was taken from me. Because most of us, you know, our souls are lying buried under the debris of our animal being. So it is, so to say, unconscious. It is not remembering. Had we purified our souls and had we strengthened our souls, then they would remember that this was the covenant that they made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَوْ تَقُولُوا إِنَّمَا أَشْرَكَ آبَاؤُنَا Or lest you should say that actually our forefathers, they associated God with Allah من قبل, before us. وَكُنَّا ذُرِّيَّةً مِّن بَعْدِهِمْ And we were their progeny. We were following them. أَفَتُهْلِكُنَا بِمَا فَعَلَ الْمُبْتَلُونَ So, oh Allah, are you going to destroy us? Because of the misdeeds of those people, they committed this error. We were their progeny. We followed. But they are the originators of this sin. So are you going to kill us and destroy us and punish us on account of the inventors of the falsehood? They were the inventors. But you know, Allah would say, okay, you were son of such and such person, he was son of such and such person. What about your soul? It was not the son of your father. It had no relationship. It was directly from me. يَسَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي So you can't take this plea. Bodily, your animal existence, your bodies, they came from the father and the mother. And the bodies of the father and the mother, they came from, you know, your grandfathers and grandmothers. But what about your souls? They are separate, absolutely separate. As we have, you know, the hadith from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala an, that each one of you in the womb of his mother, he remains 40 days nutfa, another 40 days muzgha, another alaqa, another 40 days muzgha. After these 120 days, Allah sends the angel and he breathes into him the soul which was created by before. Now he becomes a human being. وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ And this is how we detail our ayat revelations, we explain them, so that they return to the truth. وَطْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ Another incident of their history. وَطْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَى الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا And just relate to them, recite unto them the news of that person whom we gave our signs. Now here the signs can have two, both meanings. Ayat, ayatul, Kitab. Maybe he was a very big, you know, alim, a very big scholar of Torah, very knowledgeable person about Torah. He was, according to the detail that we find in Torah, he was Balaam bin Ba'ura, a very pious person, very learned person, you know, very, very good person among the Bani Israel, and he was a contemporary of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. وَقْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَى الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا We had given him our ayat, our revelations. And maybe, because he was very, very a pious person, so maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him some karamat also. You know what Quran says ayat? Mu'jizat also. Miracles that he gave to the messengers of Allah and the prophets of Allah. They are, you know, something which is against the usual physical laws. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them has been giving these miracles to messengers or prophets, but also to pious people. People, you know, who are very near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we call them karamat, as against mu'jizat. So maybe he was a person of a high spiritual stature. لَعَلَّهُمْ وَطْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَى الَّذِي آتَيْنَا وَآيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَقَ مِنْهَا But that the unlucky person, unfortunate person, he ran away from our ayat. And the details as it is given in Torah is that he fell in love with a woman, not, you know, legally married to him, and that, you know, one thing. بَلَا مَنْ كَسَبَ سَيِّئَةً وَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَتُهُ. Even one thing, you know, can destroy the whole edifice and can make all your good deeds gone in vain. فَاتْبَعُ شَيْطَانِ. And now Shaitan followed him, Satan, used to take him more and more away. Once you slip, you can make tawbah. But if Shaitan is now, you know, behind you, you're pushing you further away. فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. Oh, he became in the totally perverted person. وَلَوْ شَيْلَا رَفَعْنَاهُ بِيَا. And had we wished, we would have raised his level more due to those ayat. وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ. But he clung to the earth. What does it mean? The lowly desires of this world, the lusts of this world. Now this is what is, you know, in this parable or in this incident, it is what is being said to the people, to the ulama of Yahud. What is it? That the same is your condition. Had you accepted Islam and had you believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَوْ شَيْنَا لَنَفَعْنَاهُ بِيَا. Allah Ta'ala would have given you higher status. But you have chosen this world. You have sold the akhirah against this dunya. وَلَوْ شَيْنَا لَنَفَعْنَاهُ بِيَا وَلَكِنَّا وَخْلَدَا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. وَتَّبَاهَوَاهُ. And he followed his lusts. فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ. So the similitude, his similitude is like the similitude of dog. إِن تَعْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَسْ. Or إِن تَتْرُكْهُ يَلْهَسْ. If you drive it out, it brings, it keeps its tongue out with salivation and dyspnea. And if you leave it alone, the same is the case. ذَلِكَ مَثَلُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. Same is the similitude of people who reject our revelations. This is actually indirectly being said to the Bani Israel, to the Jews of the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقْصُصِ الْقَصَصَ. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you relate to them these incidents. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Maybe they reflect, they think about them. سَاءَ مَثَلًا الْقَوْمُ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. Bad are those, in example, who belie our revelations and ayat and signs. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. They are the people who will be doomed, who are going to be doomed. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَعْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Another very big important idea is from the basic philosophy and basic wisdom of Quran. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَعْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. And we have created for Jahannam many among the jinns as well as the humans. You know, as regards the end, so many of human beings are to go to hell. So many of the jinns are to go to hell. As if Allah has created them for hell. وَلَقَدْ زَرَعْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. What is their condition in this world, in this life? لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. They have hearts and souls, but they don't understand with it. وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا. And they have eyes, but they don't see with it. They see the seeing of animals only. If you have also seen that a car is coming and I must save myself, the dog is doing the same. What's the difference? Doesn't the dog save itself? So this seeing is, you know, seeing of the animal being. But to see the reality, اَهْلِ نَظَرْ ذَوْقِ نَظَرْ خُوبْ هَيْ لَيْكِنْ جو شَيْءِ کی حقیقت کو نہ دیکھے وہ نظر کیا. You must see the reality, not the appearance, not be deluded by the appearance. As perhaps I told you, a very big philosopher, Bradley, British philosopher, he wrote a very book, grand book, Appearance and Reality. Don't be deceived by the appearance. Try to look through the appearance to the reality, to the essence of the thing. And that is why there is a dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma arini haqiqata al-ashiya'i kama hiya. Oh Allah, show me the reality of all the things as they are. I don't want to be contented with the appearance. Oh, even the animals, you know, the dogs and the cats, they also see the appearance. So what's the difference between our seeing? So they have the eyes, but they don't see. They are seeing only like animals, not actual seeing of the human beings. وَلَهُمْ أَذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. And they have their ears, but they don't use them. They don't hear with it. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They are like cattle, animals. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. Rather, they have gone more astray, because animals were created at that very level, and man was created very high. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. If the humans reduce themselves to the level of animals, actually they are worse than animals. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. They are the people who are heedless, who are engrossed in this world. کافر کی یہ پہچان کہ آفاق میں گم ہے، مومن کی یہ پہچان کہ گم اس میں ہے آفاق. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. And to Allah belong all the good names. There are 99 names which the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم has told us, which appear in mostly in Quran and some are from Hadith. لِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدُوهُ بِهَا. So call upon him through his names, because we cannot comprehend the person of Allah. We can only know Allah through his attributes and names. آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ كَمَا هُوَ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. So always call through his names. Ya Qaharo, Ya Jabbaro, Ya Kareemo, Ya Ghaffaro. So these are the, you know, names with which you can call him. وَذَرُ الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. And you leave alone those people who are blaspheming regarding the names of Allah. سَيُجْزَوْنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. They will be recompensed for what they are doing. وَمِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا أُمَّةٌ يَهْدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ. And among our creatures whom we have created, there are communities. There will remain always. As the Prophet said, among my ummah, there will remain always a group. لَا تَذَالُ فِي أُمَّتِي تَائِفَةٌ قَائِمِينَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ. One community, one group will remain forever. They will change, you know, just like the torch bearer of the Olympic torch. The torch bearer changes, but the torch is the same. He runs for a distance, then hands over the torch to the other. So from one group to the other, from one party to the other, it's changing. But you know, at no time, there will be none, you know, on the right path. People will remain. وَمِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا أُمَّةٌ يَهْدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ. They will lead people to the right path with truth. وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ. And they will be deciding affairs according to justice. وَالَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا سَنَسْتَدْرِجُهُمْ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And as for those who disbelieve and belie our revelations, we shall step by step lead them to the destruction from whence they know not. وَأُمْلِي لَهُمْ. And I will give them respite. I won't, you know, seize upon them immediately. If you have chosen the wrong path, okay, go. Go, go. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them the respite, so that all the evil in them can come out, and they prove to be what they are really, what they have in their souls. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will recompense them, will give them the punishment that is due to them. وَأُمْلِي لَهُمْ. And I give them respite. In the قَيْدِ مَتِينَ. Surely my plans, you know, and my tricks, they are very, very strong. أَوَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا مَا. أَوَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا. Don't these people reflect and think about what? مَا بِصَاحِبِهِمْ مِنْ جِنَّةِ. There's no madness in their fellow. Who is he, that fellow? In their companion, who is he? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because they used to say, he's majnoon. He has gone crazy. Sahirun majnoon. But you know, are they saying it seriously? Don't they contemplate? If they contemplate, if they think seriously, the truth, you know, will come before them. مَا بِصَاحِبٍ مِّن جِنَّةِ. Their fellow being their, you know, because he was a brother of theirs, belonging to the same tribe. He was son of Abdullah ibn Abi Talib, ibn Abdul Muttalib. So actually he was one of them. No, your sahib, your companion, he has no madness, no craziness, nothing of the sort. In huwa illa naziru mubin. Only he is the plain warner. He has been appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to warn you. Awalam yanduru fi malakuti samawati wal ard. Don't they look and contemplate and try to understand the governance of this whole universe of the heavens and the earth? Wama khalaqa Allahu min shay. And are they not contemplating and thinking over whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created? وَالْعَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ قَدْ اِقْتَرَبَ أَجَلُهُمْ. And it is just possible that their fixed time is now approaching. The period of respite is coming to an end. It's just possible. They shouldn't delay now. They should make haste in accepting the truth and believing in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Maybe that their respite, period of respite is coming to an end. And you know the hour, as-sa'ah, ajaluhum, that might be very near. فَبِأَيِّ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَهُ يُؤْمِنُونَ. So in what discourse after this book and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all these revelations are they going to believe? If they have not believed up till now, two-thirds of the Quran had been revealed. Because as I told you, these are the last of the Makki surahs. And two-thirds of Quran is Makki. So at this is the time, you know. They have listened to everything. And if they are not believing in now this, on what thing will they believe? مَنْ يُضْلِ اللَّهُ فَلَا هَذِيَ لَهُ. Whomsoever Allah has declared to have gone astray, He has put a seal on it. Nobody, you will find no person who can take him to guidance now. فَلَا هَذِيَ لَهُ. No person who can lead him to the right path. وَيَذَرُهُمْ فِي تُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. And Allah will leave them in their insolence and rebellion, wandering blindly. Go now. The way you have selected, the path that you have adopted, go and proceed. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are asking you, inquiring you, about the doomsday. أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا. When will it come? That sa'ah, that the ajal, you know, ajal of a person is the time of the death. Ajal of a nation or community is the time of respite that Allah grants to it before giving them the last punishment. And ajal of the whole world is the doomsday. So these are three ajal, you know, the plural of ajal. Now they are asking about that ajal of the whole world. When will the doomsday come? Tell them, the knowledge of doomsday is only with my Lord. Nobody is going to disclose it to about its time, but He only. Sakulat fi samawati wal ard. It is loaded, inbuilt in the heavens and the earth. What does it mean? I have the death within me. My own body metabolism is going on. And you know its limits are already set. So death doesn't come to me from outside. It is within me. It only appears at a time. In the same way, in this creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for a fixed period. What does it mean? The death is inbuilt in this creation. سَقُلَتْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَاللَّهُ. It is loaded or inbuilt in the heavens and the earth. لَا تَعْتِيكُمْ إِلَّا بَغْتَى. It will not come to you, but suddenly. يَسْأَلُونَكَ كَأَنَّكَ حَفِيٌّ عَنْهَا. They are asking you as if you are very much eagerly in search of it. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Tell them, the knowledge of this that doomsday is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but most of the people don't know it. قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي دَفْحًا وَلَا ضَرًّا. Say to them, I don't have any power, even for my own self, for any benefit or any loss. I'm also in the hands of my Lord, wholly and solely. لَا أَمْلِكُ. I don't have the power, or any good or harm, or to myself. إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides. وَلَوْ كُنْتُ عَالَمُ الْغَيْبَ لَاسْتَخْسَرْتُ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ. Had I known the ghaib, the unseen, I would have gathered and amassed much of the bounties or much of the wealth, everything. وَلَوْ كُنْتُ عَالَمُ الْغَيْبَ لَاسْتَخْسَرْتُ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ. وَمَا مَسَّنِيَ السُّوءُ. And no harm would have ever come to me, had I known all the unseen. In ana illa nazirun wa bashir. I am nothing except a bearer of glad tidings and a warner. They call me yuminun, and that also for those who believe. Who don't believe, I am nothing for them. Huwa alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahidatin wa ja'ala minha zawjaha. This ayah appeared in the very beginning of the same universe. Khalaqa, but here is هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. It is He who created you from one being, one soul. فَجَعَلَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا. And from that very species, He created for Him a mate. زَوْجَهَا لَيَسْكُنَ إِلَيْهَا. So that He finds the repose and satisfaction in her. فَلَمَّا تَغَشَّاهَا. When He covers her, حَمَلَتْ حَمْلًا خَفِيفًا. She has a load, but which is very light. In the very beginning, you know, the pregnancy, it's not felt, neither by the woman, nor it can be seen, it is not apparent. حَمَلَتْ حَمْلًا خَفِيفًا فَمَرَّتْ بِهِ. She goes about with it, unnoticed. فَلَمَّا أَثْقَلَتْ. But when she grows heavy, دَعَوَ اللَّهَ رَبَّهُمَا. Now both of them, the husband and the wife, they call upon Allah. لَيْنْ آتَيْتَنَا صَالِحًا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. If you grant us this child, safe and sound and good, goodly child, goodly offspring, we shall be very thankful to you. We shall be from among the thankful and grateful people. فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمَا صَالِحًا. And when Allah gave that child to them, safe and sound in body, physique, جَعَلَا لَهُ شُرَكَا فِي مَا آتَاهُمَا. Now they are assigning about him gods. Well, this was the kirpa of Fala, you know, karam of Fala, kirpa of karam. And this is the grace from that goddess, or it was from the grace and blessing of that god. Now they are attributing it to the gods. جَعَلَا لَهُ شُرَكَا فِي مَا آتَاهُمَا. فَتَعَالَ اللَّهُ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Much exalted is Allah from all that they are associating. أَيُشْرِكُونَ مَا لَا يَخْلُقُ شَيْئًا وَهُمْ يُخْلَقُونَ. Do they want to associate with Him who don't create anything? They are themselves created. وَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ لَهُمْ نَصْرًا وَلَا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَنْصُرُونَ. And they don't have any power for them, to help them. And they cannot help their own selves. How to help? What to speak of helping others? They can't help themselves. When Prophet ﷺ himself is saying, قُلَّا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا. I don't have any power, even for myself, for any good thing or for any harm, you know, which might come to me. إِلَّا يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. It's all in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what to speak of others? وَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ لَهُمْ نَصْرًا وَلَا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَنْصُرُونَ. وَإِنْ تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى الْهُدَى لَا يَتَّبِعُوكُمْ سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْكُمْ أَدْعَوْتُمُوهُمْ أَمْ أَنْتُمْ صَامِتُونَ. Now, O believers in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these are the concluding remarks. O Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you go on calling them towards the right path, towards the guidance, they are not going to follow you. They have already reached that point of no return. Because this is one of the last Makki surahs, and we find in the first Madani surah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ. This is actually not in the beginning. When you know 12 long years had passed, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had been preaching to them, conveying to them, reciting over them the ayat of Allah, ayat after ayat, surahs after surahs, for 12 long years. And they didn't pay any heed, and they decided, although their hearts had testified that this is correct, although they couldn't meet the challenge. فَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَاتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِّثْلِهِ. They could never meet the challenge. So actually they were self-defeated. But because of their arrogance, because of their positions, we are the chiefs. How can we obey him? Because the Prophet, if you accept him as a prophet, you have to obey him. It was actually out of their arrogance, you know, that they denied. Now due to this, a seal has been put on their hearts. Now, O Muslims, even if you go on trying to convert them to Islam and to call them to Islam, they are not going to hearken to you, to listen to you. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ أَدْعَوْتُمُوهُمْ أَمْ أَنْتُمْ صَامِتُونَ. It's just equal to you whether you continue calling them to the right path or you remain silent. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ عِبَادًا أَمْثَالَكُمْ. Now there are two types of, you know, shirk. One is the apparent shirk, and that is idol worship that they were doing. But They said that these, you know, figures which we have carved out of stone, they are not the real gods, as I told you. They are only the symbols. We want to meditate. But they represent the gods and goddesses who are in the heaven. And they are the beloveds of Allah. The, you know, the angels, Lat, Uzza, Manat, they are all daughters of Allah. So actually we have carved these figures so as to meditate through them and to reach those gods and goddesses. So now these two things. Directly before them is the idol. But whom they are really calling is not the idol. They know that this idol cannot do anything. We have carved ourselves from the stone. It neither hears nor talks. But actually that is the medium through which they are calling the angels, or for that matter, maybe the past, your pious people. Just as you know, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, calling people, you will find calling him, help us. Although they should call only on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا تَدُوْ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. But you know, the souls of the departed, maybe the anbiya, prophets, or ya Allah, the pious men. But you know, these two things you should keep separate in mind. Now in the first ayah, these deities whom they are calling through these idols, they are referred. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ عِبَادٌ أَمْثَالَكُمْ. Look, O people, to whom you are praying besides Allah, they are also bondsmen like you. If you are calling an angel, he is a bondman to Allah. If you are calling Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, he is a bondsman to Allah. If you are calling Ali, Ya Ali Madad, who is Ali? Ali is also a bondsman to Allah. Those whom you are calling, الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ عِبَادٌ أَمْثَالَكُمْ, they are also like you. They were also created. They were also human beings. Or they are the angels. Even angels are bondsmen to Allah. فَدْعُوهُمْ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَالِحِينَ. Go on calling them. If you are true, let them respond to you. They are not going to respond to you. But rather, on the day of judgment, they will refute your claim. You are not calling us. You are telling a lie. Because, you know, they will feel ashamed in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That these people, you know, they have made us equal to you, O Allah. They will be ashamed of it. So that is actually given elsewhere in the Quran. Now come to the idols. They were using them as their medium. Allahum arjunun yamshuna biha. Now this thing that they are the media only, we are not worshipping them. This was known to only the intellectuals of them. Only Radha Krishnan could say it. A common man would say, oh yes, this is the Lord, this is God. So now this ayah is referring to them. Allahum arjunun yamshuna biha. Have they got any feet with which they can walk? You have made them feet also. You know, an idol is standing on two legs. They have feet and legs. But can he walk with it? Am lahum yabtishuna biha. You have, you know, carved the hands also, but can they hold with it? Am lahum ayunun yusiruna biha. Have they the eyes with which they can see? Am lahum adanun yasmauna biha. Or the ears you have carved, can they see with these ears? قُلَدُوا شُرَكَاكُمْ ثُمَّ كُيدُونِي فَلَا تُنْزِرُونَ. Now this is the challenging, you know, mode which we found in the end of Suratul Anam also. Okay, go on calling your associate gods and then try all your tricks, whatever you have against me, and don't give me any respite. I don't ask from you any respite. Do it whatever you live. قُلَيْمَلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ إِنِّي عَامِلْ. You do whatever you can do. And I am also doing whatever is in my power. Now the result is with Allah. إِنَّ وَلِيَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْكِتَابِ وَهُوَ يَتَوَلَّ الصَّالِحِينَ. Verily, the protector, my protector is Allah. You might do anything, try any trick. You might plan anything against me. My protector is Allah. إِنَّ وَلِيَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْكِتَابِ, who has sent down this book on me. وَهُوَ يَتَوَلَّ الصَّالِحِينَ, and he protects all the righteous people. And it is his guaranteed protection. وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ لَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ نَصْرَكُمْ وَلَا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَنصُرُونَ. As for those whom you are calling, whether they are the angels or the jinns, of the souls of the departed, awliya Allah, departed messengers of Allah, prophets of Allah, whatsoever you are calling them, or you are calling these idols, or anything else. In وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ لَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ نَصْرَكُمْ. They don't have any authority, any power to help you. وَلَا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَنصُرُونَ. What to speak of helping you, they can't help themselves. وَإِن تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى الْهُدَى لَا يَسْمَعُوا. Now this again refers to the people. And here the Prophet ﷺ and the believers are being addressed. وَإِن تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى الْهُدَى. Just like the ayah number 193. This ayah number 198 and 193, they are very close to each other. وَإِن تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى الْهُدَى. O believers, O mu'minun, if you call them, go on calling them towards hidayah, towards guidance. لَا يَسْمَعُوا. They will never listen. We have put upon their hearts a seal, and on their listening a seal. خَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ. On their hearing also, a seal has been put. وَتَرَاهُمْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْكَ. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you see them looking towards you, as if they are seeing you. وَهُمْ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ. Actually they are not seeing. They are blind. Spiritually they are blind. Spiritually they are dead. Spiritually they are deaf. They are deaf and dumb. سُمُّن بُكْمُن عُمْيُن. فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ. In the second section of Suratul Baqarah. سُمُّن بُكْمُن عُمْيُن. Well, you know, Abu Jahl was not blind. Abu Lahab was not blind. He had very big eyes, you know. He was a very beautiful person. But you know, he was dead spiritually. He had no soul within him now. The soul was dead. He had eyes, but animal eyes only. Not the real human eyes. He had the ears, but the animal ears only. Not the real human ears. So that is the condition. They are spiritually dead. You think they are looking towards you? They are not. They are not looking. Khudillaf. O Prophet, you stick to forgiveness. Keep on forgiving them. Khudillaf. Ramur bil urf. And continuing. Continue ordaining them or enjoining them whatever is right. Rari zanil jahili. And just ignore and turn yourself away from these people who are ignorant, who are spiritually dead. Don't spend your time much on them. Don't engage into any arguments with them. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ. Very important ayah. And if you have some provocation from shaitan, after all, Muhammad was also a human being. Sometimes he felt angry over something which was said to him. Allah says this anger, if it is coming, it is actually due to the provocation of the shaitan. So if a provocation comes to you from shaitan, fasta'iz billah, immediately take refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qul a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Fasta'iz billah. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Verily, He is all-hearing, all-knowing. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَارَ إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. As for those people who have the taqwa, God-fearing people, God-conscious people, if an instigation comes to them, touches them from shaitan, تَذَكَّرُوا. Immediately, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was something within me. Shaitan had instigated me. There was some waswasa. Allazi yuwaswasu fi suduri nas. Oh, I had a waswasa. Something from shaitan. They remember Allah. Faizahum mubsirun. And then they see the realities and all things. And they feel enlightened. Wa ikhwanuhum yamuddunahum fil ghayy. As for their friends and their brothers. You know, shaitans have brothers in human beings. They when commit something wrong, now they don't remember Allah, they don't repent, they don't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in humility, asking His forgiveness. Rather these, their friends, their shaitans, you know, yamuddunahum, they drag them further into the error, fil ghayy. ثُمَّ لَا يُخْسِرُونَ, and they stop not short. They push him to the last end, you know, and they throw him finally into the fire of hell. وَإِذَا لَمْ تَعْتِهِمْ بِآيَةٍ, and when, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you didn't bring them the miracle that they wanted, they demanded. قَالُوا لَوْلَا اجْتَبَيْتَهَا, he said, why couldn't you bring forth a miracle? That was the argument, you know, we have found from the very beginning of Suratul Anam. These two surah go to make a pair. What was discussed in the beginning in Surah Al-Anam, but there was detailed discussion on that issue. In the end of Suratul Araf, you have a reference to it again. وَإِسْلَمْ تَعْتِهِمْ بِآيَا, if when you have not brought them the miracle that they demanded, قَالُوا لَوْلَا اجْتَبَيْتَهَا, they said, why couldn't you fetch and bring any miracle? قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَتَّبِعُ مَا يُحَى إِلَيَّ مِنْ رَبِّي, tell him, I didn't make any claim that I have the authority to show you the miracles. My only point is, my only stand is, my only claim is that I follow whatever is being revealed to me from my Lord. That's all. So you have to judge me according to my claim. I've never claimed that لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي مَلَكُ وَلَا أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبِ. This ayah we read last night. هَذَا بَصَائِرُ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, these are the enlightenments which are coming to you from your Lord. وَهُدَمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ, they are the guidance and the mercy for those people who believe. وَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرَانُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا, and when Quran is being recited, listen to it most attentively. سَمِعَ يَسْمَعُ, to hear. إِسْتَمَعَ يَسْتَمِعُ, listening with the maximum attention. استمعوا له, you focus your attention and listen it with attention. وَأَنْصِتُوا, and keep yourself quiet. Now don't talk, don't speak. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, so that you may have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفًا, and O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these are the concluding ayat. You remember your Lord in your heart, تَضَرُّعًا, with humility, humbly, وَخِيفًا, and with fear, humility and fear, دُونَ الْجَارِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ, without loudness in your voice. There was khufiya word, you know, khufiya. And here, khifa is khauf. Khufiya, dun al-jahre min al-qawl. This is the second expression. Not without the loudness in your voice. Bil ghudumwe wal asal. In the mornings and the evenings. Wala takum min al-ghafileen. And you should never be from among the neglectful people who are heedless. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِهِ, verily, those highly placed angels who are very near to their Lord, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِهِ, they are never too proud to worship Him. They are bondsmen. They worship Him all the time. وَيُسَبِّحُونَهُ, and they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. وَلَهُ يَسْجُدُونَ, and they keep on prostrating before Him. And we have also to prostrate, because this is the ayah of prostration. أَقُولَ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمِينَ.
الله أكبر الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzim.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.